Hi, I'm Susan Rutledge, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to make these six simple pattern brushes in Adobe Illustrator. And they're so easy to make, you're not even going to need a bounding box to make them perfectly seamless. So let's move to a blank document and get started. The first thing I'll do is get the ellipse tool, keyboard shortcut L, and click on the artboard to open the ellipse dialog box. I'll type in 0.3 inches for the width, tab down and type in 0.3 inches for the height and say OK. Then I want to make a copy of the circle. I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and I'll grab hold of the circle and hold down the option key and drag, and that's going to drag a copy. And as I drag, I'll hold the shift key down so I drag in a perfect horizontal line. And when I see the word intersect, I'm going to release my mouse. If you don't see the word intersect, go up to View, down to Smart Guides, and turn them on here, or you can toggle them on with the keyboard shortcut Command-U. Now, while the copy is still selected, I can duplicate the move of copying the circle and moving it to the right with the keyboard shortcut Command-D. Now, I have three circles side by side. I'm going to change the color of the far right one. I'll move to the Properties panel and click on blue, and then select this middle one and change it to red. And then I'll select all three of the circles and group them, keyboard shortcut Command G. Now I'll move up to Window and down to Brushes panel, which is what we're going to need to create our first pattern brush. I'll move to this bottom bar and click on the new brush icon. That brings up the new brush dialog box. I'll choose pattern brush and say OK. And because the design was selected on the artboard, when I selected pattern brush, Illustrator has already turned this into our first pattern brush. I'm going to give it a name. I'll just call this circles. Leave all of the other options the same and say OK. Then I'll grab the Brushes tab and drag and dock it next to the Layers tab on the right side of my workspace. Now for our second design, we're simply going to rotate this one. So I'll get the Rotate tool, keyboard shortcut R. I want the white circle to be on top, so I'm going to drag down. And as I drag, I'm going to hold the shift key down because that causes the rotations to snap in 45 degree increments. And when I see minus 90 degrees, I'll release my mouse. Now I can go back over to the Brushes panel, click on the new brush icon, choose pattern brush, and say OK. Here's our new pattern brush. I'm going to call this one vertical circles. Leave everything else the same and say OK. So we have our first two pattern brushes. I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and move this design up out of the way and get the rectangle tool, keyboard shortcut M, and click on the artboard to open the rectangle dialog box. I'm going to type in 0.4 inches for the width, tab down and type in 0.4 inches for the height, and say OK. Now I'm going to rotate the square. I'll get the Rotate tool, keyboard shortcut R, and hold down the Shift key to snap in a 45 degree increment. And when I see 45 degrees, I'm going to release my mouse. Then I'll move to the Properties panel and remove the stroke. Then get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and I'm going to make a copy of the diamond. So I'll hold down the option key and drag to the right and hold the shift key down so I drag in that same horizontal line. And when I see the word intersect, it's kind of hard to see because it's pink text on red, but it's there, I'll release my mouse. Now I'm going to make a blue rectangle to go behind the diamonds, and it's got to be the exact same width as the diamonds. So I'll select them and come over to the Properties panel, and here is the value of the width of those. I'll highlight it and copy it to my clipboard, keyboard shortcut Command C, and then click on the artboard to deselect the diamonds and get the rectangle tool again, keyboard shortcut M. Click on the artboard to open up that dialog box for the width, which is going to be the same width as the diamonds. All I have to do is paste the value that's on my clipboard with the keyboard shortcut Command V. Then for the height, I'm going to type in 0.75 inches and say OK. I'll change the color of the rectangle to blue, then get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and drag it over here on top of the diamonds. Now it's covering them. I need to move it behind the diamonds. I'll do that with the keyboard shortcut Shift Command left bracket. Now I'm going to make an adjustment here. I want to select the left diamond and change its color to white. Then I'll hold down the Shift key so that I can also select the red diamond. And then I'm going to group those, keyboard shortcut Command G. Now I'll select the rectangle and the diamonds, come over to the Properties panel, and I'm going to click on Horizontal Align Center and Vertical Align Center. So now they're perfectly aligned and we're ready to make our third pattern brush. I'll come over to Brushes, down to the new brush icon, choose Pattern Brush, and say OK. We have our third pattern brush. Let's call this Diamonds and say OK. I'll move this design up out of the way. Then I'll get the Ellipse tool, keyboard shortcut L, and click on the artboard to open the Ellipse dialog box. And I'm going to type in 0.5 inches for the width, tab down, type in 0.5 inches for the height, and say OK. Then I'll move to the Properties panel. I'm going to remove the fill, and I'm going to change this stroke to 3 points, and change the color to red. Then I'll click on the artboard to close out the swatches panel and move up to Object, down to Path, over and down to Offset Path. And when the Offset Path dialog box opens up, I'm going to type in minus 0.09 and leave everything else the same and say OK. Then with that circle selected, I'll come over here and change the color to blue. Click on the artboard to close the swatches panel and repeat the move one more time. Go up to Object, down to Path, over and down to Offset Path. And the dialog box comes up with the same offset we used before. I'll leave that value and say OK. Then come over and change the color of that circle to red. Click on the artboard to close out the swatches panel and get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and select all three of the circles and group them, keyboard shortcut Command G, and we have our fourth pattern brush design. I'll go to the brushes panel, down to the new brush icon, choose pattern brush, say OK, and we'll name this one target circles and say OK. Then I'll move this design out of the way. For the fifth design, I'll get the line segment tool, keyboard shortcut backslash, and click on the artboard to open the line segment tool options dialog box. I'll type in 1 inch for the length, and I'm going to type in 0 for the angle and say OK. Then I'll move to the Properties panel. I already have a 3-point stroke, which is what I want, but I'm going to change the color to blue. Then I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V. I'm going to copy this line. I'll hold down the Option key and just drag a copy over to the left. And then before I do anything else with my line segment, I'm going to come up to Object and down and click on Expand. And the most important thing is to make sure that the stroke is checked and say OK. Now I'm going to make a copy of my line segment, but I'm going to copy a different way this time. I'll go up to Object, down to Transform, over and down to Move. When the Move dialog box opens up, I've got to change these values. I don't want a horizontal move, so I'll type in 0. For the vertical move, I'm going to type in 0.2, and I can actually uncheck preview and check it back, and we see that it's moved, but I don't want it just to move. I want to copy it, so I'll click copy. Then I want to duplicate that action with the keyboard shortcut Command D, and I'll do that two more times, Command D and Command D. Now I'll select the second line, hold down the Shift key so I can select multiples, and click on that fourth line, come over and change the color of that to red, and then select all five of these lines, go up to Effect, down to Warp, over and down to arch and click here. I'll leave the bend at 50%. I'm not going to add a distortion, and I'll say OK. Now, what I want you to see is the edges on the left and on the right of the arch lines are vertical. So when the design is placed end to end in the pattern brush, it's going to line up seamlessly, which is what we want. I'll zoom in so you can see that a little closer. Then I'll delete that copy. Now let's come over to this line segment, which we did not expand. I'll select it, come back up to Effect. I can choose Apply Arch. That's the most recent effect I've used. And we have that same arch that we have here, but look at the ends of the arch. They are not vertical like the design here, which means if I'd use this kind of a line that's not expanded and place it end to end, it would not match up perfectly, and this would not make for a seamless pattern brush. I'm going to zoom back out and select these blue lines and delete them. So if you're going to be applying an arch to a line segment that you're going to use in a pattern brush, be sure before you apply the arch to expand that line segment. Now select these five lines and we'll come to the brushes panel, click on the new brush icon, choose pattern brush and say OK. I'll call this red, white, blue arch and say OK. Then for the last pattern brush, we'll use a variation of this design. So I'll click on the artboard to deselect it and select just the red lines. So I'll select this red, hold down the Shift key and select this red, come over to the properties panel and change the color to white. And then I'll select all five of the lines, and even though I started out with the line segments here expanded, I'm going to have to expand this appearance for the next step to work. So I'll move up to Object and choose Expand Appearance. Now I'll add a background color to this design, and it's got to be the exact same width as my line segments are. I'll get the rectangle tool, keyboard shortcut M. I'll start on the top left. I'll go above the top line, drag to the right, and make sure I get all of the bottom line in, and then release my mouse. I'm going to change the fill color to red, click on the artboard to close the swatches panel, and I'll move the red rectangle to the back, keyboard shortcut Shift Command left bracket, then get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and select the rectangle and the lines, and get the Shape Builder tool, keyboard shortcut Shift M, and hold down the Option key and drag across the bottom part I don't want, and remove the top part I don't want. And just so you know, this last step of removing the parts I didn't want is what wouldn't work until I expanded the appearance of those lines again. So then with this design selected, I'll go back to the brushes panel, come down and click on the new brush icon, choose pattern brush, say OK, and we'll call this red background arch and say OK. I'll group the design, keyboard shortcut Command G, get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and move this up and out of the way. And now it's time for us to test our pattern brushes. I'll move to the Layers panel and hide the layer that has all of the designs on it, and I'm going to reveal a layer that has templates for us to apply our pattern brushes to. Pattern brushes can be applied to any kind of a stroke. These are simply rectangles and circles. So we'll start down here at the bottom. I'll move to the Brushes panel and apply the circles pattern brush, and I'm going to make a slight change here. So I'll go to the Properties panel. I'm going to reduce the size of the stroke, so I'll select 0.5, and you see how changing the size of the stroke changes the look of the pattern brush. Now I'll come up and select the circle, go back to the Brushes panel, choose our vertical circles pattern brush, and I'm going to do the same thing. I'll change this to 0.5, and again we have a really nice seamless pattern brush. Now let's move down to this circle, go back to the Brushes panel, try our third pattern brush. I'm going to click to deselect it just so that you can see that this is perfectly seamless. We don't see any gaps in this blue background, and that's because the diamonds and the rectangle were exactly the same width. But I'm going to change the size of that stroke, so I'll go to the Properties panel, select this circle, change this to 0.5, then click on the artboard to deselect it. Then I'll move up to this rectangle, go back to the Brushes panel, and let's check out our target circles. And that turned out great as well. Next, I'll select this rectangle and apply this pattern brush and click on the artboard to deselect it. And this turned out really nice. And notice how that design does fit end to end perfectly and the pattern brush is seamless. Remember, that's because I expanded the line segment before I created the arch. For the final pattern brush, we'll click here and choose this pattern brush, and I'll click on the artboard to deselect it. Let's see what happens if we make that just a little smaller. I'll select it, move over to the Properties panel, and change this to 0.75. And just like the other pattern brushes, this one is seamless as well, and I think this might be my favorite one. I hope you've enjoyed this video and you've learned some things about making simple pattern brushes in Adobe Illustrator. Of course, you can get much more complex, and I have a lot of videos that you can check out if you want to delve into this deeper. But as I've created these designs, I bet you've already come up with some ideas of your own, and you're going to be whipping out pattern brushes right and left. And finally, I'd like to invite you to subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell so you don't miss any of my future tutorials, and I'll look forward to seeing you again next time. Thank you so much for watching. Bye now.